Hello and welcome to True Guidance Tarot. I'm Adriana Teodoro-Dier. I'm a spiritual medium and intuitive reader. I have a message for Virgo this week, this time, and I have asked my guides and spirit for a message that is deeply meaningful and significant for you this week. So let's get straight on with your reading. Kind of thinking of where to start with you, because you start and then we end where we start, so it's just kind of funny. We've got the Ace of Wands for the energy around you, and so this is a new opportunity. This can be a new job, it can be a new passion, and I say passion because that can mean love affair or a new love, but love is also not just with another person, right? It's a new something you'd love to do, a new opportunity, a new something. But you feel that spark again, and it feels like this is the right time and the right thing to do. However, you respond with the Emperor, which is, it's very harsh, cold kind of energy. And it's like, nope, not unless it's on my terms. And so you have this spark that wants to grow. It's not even fully formed yet. If this were a relationship we're talking about, this is like the initial phase. Maybe this is even just like looking at someone and setting up a first date. But already you're setting down the boundaries. You're setting down these pillars like, nope, unless it's on my terms, I am having nothing to do with it. So there's a time and a place for that energy, but when something is just starting, you need to kind of go with it and flow with it and see where it's going to go. Now, if you're not a tarot person or don't really know what tarot is, tarot goes in order when we're in the minor arcana. So this is a one, it goes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of wands, etc. The reason why I'm telling you this is in your advice, it goes to the two of wands. So the one is trying to progress to the two. We're trying to get from the beginning stage to the development stage where we start to see where this could go, right? What is the potential for this new passion, this new spark, new love? Where is it kind of, where is spirit guiding me to go? And because you have responded with this control, with this everything on my terms energy, this is what you get. You've got the Nine of Swords looking at the Three of Swords. Now look at this. This is all nice and sunny, and this is all shrouded in your fears. So this is anxiety about heartbreak. That's really all it is. You're worried that if you let go of your control, you let that guard down, you're going to betray yourself again, and then you're going to feel isolated. But this is the important thing. You've already done it. By putting your control down and saying, nope, not unless it's on my terms, not unless it follows the rules, not unless it's my way, you've already cut your heart out. That sounds horrible. But the thing with this card is it's self-imposed. She stabbed herself through the heart. She breaks her own heart. So this comes along, this is your heart waking up saying, hey, I want to go this direction. Hey, Virgo, I'm ready to go. Let's see where this takes us because I'm feeling excitement. I'm feeling alive. And you're like, no, we're not doing that again because last time when we tried that, do you remember how hurt we got? Do you remember how much we lost? Do you remember how it didn't work out? And so you cut off your own heart. Your heart is waking up and talking to you for a reason. And what I think is visually interesting is I feel more power coming off of this card than I do the Emperor, who should be more powerful. But your heart's trying to talk to you, and there's either something you have to learn or something that you need to grow from or some place this experience is going to take you that's going to open you up in a different way, that you're going to discover a different facet of yourself. There's something in that. This is not just like, yeah, I tried knitting and it was great, or I dated this guy and it didn't really work out. This is deeper than that. It's what am I going to gain spiritually by this experience? It doesn't matter if it works out or doesn't work out, and I know you want it to work out in a certain way, but it really doesn't matter because your heart wants to wake up and it wants the process of whatever is going to happen. I think that's the best way I can explain it to you. It doesn't care about a goal. It cares about the process. And we tend to care about the goals, right? That's what's going on here. The Two of Wands, where is this going to go? What's this going to look like? Where is my goal? Where am I going to end up? And that's why you've got all this anxiety, because you don't know. Your head can't figure it out. Your head can only go to the past and dredge up experiences that were like this one that didn't quite work out. But your heart's saying, this is a new beginning. And really, this is amazing. I'm so excited about this. You can tell I'm going to like fall off my chair. The Emperor's four. This is a one. One plus four is five, which is the number of change. I'm doing some numerology here. Now, if we do three plus two plus nine, that also condenses to a five. If you have questions about that, ask me in the comments. I will tell you how I got that. But we've got two fives. So we've got change and we've got change. Five is movement, it's change, it's difference. That's why your heart, it wants this, because it's change and it's different. That's why your control doesn't want this, because it's change and it's different. But five plus five is 10, which is a one, which is a new beginning. So this whole process is starting something new for you, because it's a new phase of your heart. It's a new phase of your soul growth. And that's the bigger picture. It doesn't matter these mundane details if they work out or not, but you have to understand that you've already broken your heart if you say no to this experience. So I'm going to leave you with that. Lovely thought, right? Please subscribe to this channel and like if you haven't already. It really helps to keep us in touch, and it keeps us getting this information flowing from the guides to me, to you, so that we keep this circle of positive energy going. And if you're interested in a one-on-one reading, they're really fun, really awesome. And I am taking bookings right now through my website in the description below. TrueGuidanceTarot.com is the website. And I look forward to seeing you next week.